Hello everyone! Today I'm going to teach you how to create your own calendar in InDesign. And you can even print your own calendar by using one of those photo services that will print your book online. So this here is the finished product, it's a photo book. And in here I have layouted a calendar and printed it with a photo service. We're going to first talk about the general page layout, how to get those things done. Then the calendar itself is created by a plugin that is called Calendar Wizard. I give a short introduction to this plugin. And then we're going to compile all those things and get them ready to upload to your printing service online. So let's get started with this tutorial. We're going to create a new document. And you should check on the website that will print your photo book that you get the right dimensions. So in my case, it's 145 mm by 190 mm per page. We want to have facing pages activated, and in my case I need 16 pages. I'm going to create 17 because we need to delete one later on. In the margins I would say we take 10 mm. Now you can go on OK, and we see here our first page. We have of course facing pages. But we don't really start on the first page here, so we would need to start with the double page in the beginning for our cover and back of the photo book. So we would need to get rid of this, and we want to allow document pages to shuffle, and now we can just simply delete this page. We can click on the bin here, and it gets deleted. Now I have my 16 pages for the photo book. To generate our calendar, we're not going to do this by hand. We're going to use a script that is called Calendar Wizard, and you can download it from this website. You find the link in the YouTube description. If you don't know where to install the script inside InDesign, you can go onto your script panel. And if you right click on a folder, you can go on Reveal and Finder, and this will show you the place where you can put your script. Just put the folder that you downloaded into here, and it will appear as Calendar Wizard as a single folder in your script panel. To start creating a calendar, just double click on Calendar Wizard, and in here you can customize the look of your calendar. In my case I have only space for 7 months, so I'm going to select those months in here, and then I can decide which language should the calendar have. In this case I go with German. I start the week on Monday. You can include a lot of different options in here, but I want to have a simple calendar in this case. And in here, this is really important, we're going to select current document. This will add the calendar to the end of our document. We can go on OK, and this will generate our calendar. Now we see we got a new calendar in here, and it has added those to the end of the document. We need to distribute them, one calendar on each spread. So I'm going to do this for you really quick. And also you need to think about that on the first page, this is going to be our cover. So we don't want to have any calendars on the first spread. So we move this down. All right, now we have one calendar on every spread in our document. You also want to make sure to check the calendars on the right order again, that you print them in the right order. We want to now format our calendars because this doesn't look so nice at the moment. So one thing you can do, you can adjust the height of your columns and of your cells in here, like this. And if you mess something up, you can always select the thing and go on right click. And then here you can, for example, distribute the rows evenly, and this will give you the right distribution again. However, one easy thing to also adjust your calendar is to select the whole thing. And in here you can select the size of the calendar cells. So for example, we're going with 15 mm by 15 mm. Like this. With German calendars, we only use the first two letters of a word if we use an abbreviation. So we're going to delete the third letter in here. And now we can select the whole thing and also adjust the spacing. So we want to have it spaced in the center, for example. And we're also going to increase the text size to 30 in this case. Yeah, maybe this is a little bit too big. Let's see how much is possible here. Yeah, 25 is also fine. We can also change the color, for example, from the Sundays. We can do this in the color panel in here. And you want to make sure at the moment we have the cells selected in here. So if I change the color now, it would affect the background of my cells. This is not what I want. I need to select the T for text. And now I can give, for example, those Sundays a red color. We can take a look at our calendar. Maybe we still should get rid of the borders in here. We again select the whole thing. Make sure that we select all of those lines in here. And we set the line width to 0 pt. And there we have our nice calendar. We would do this now for every page. But I first want to get the pictures in here. So I see if this calendar setup looks nice with the actual picture. To get the pictures in here, we want to create a new layer. And we want to place this layer below our layer which contains the calendar. If we go on the master page, master A, let's zoom out a little bit. We can insert a text frame, this one, and we're going to drag it over the whole width of our master. This now adds this picture frame onto every page, and from here we can just drag and drop our pictures into our file. Let's get our pictures. We can select all of them and just drag them into InDesign. And now you can just click and it will paste your picture onto the background. We're going to do this on every page. Now you want to make sure that the picture itself has the right framing, so you can double click on the picture and can adjust the size of the picture. So this is going to be our front page. So this is the cover and this is the back of the book. And on the next page you see as the pictures are on a layer that is below our calendar layer, they appear behind the calendar itself. You also see the picture I use in here is not in the right format. So we want to maybe rotate the whole spread. And you can do this by selecting the spread. And then in view, you can rotate spread counterclockwise. If we export our document, it will still save the document in the right dimensions. But this way it's easier for us to do the layout on those pages as well. So here also double click and we hold the shift key and rotate our picture like this. And then we position it on our page. Also hold the shift key while resizing a picture. And we also want, of course, to rotate our calendar like this. If you have positioned your pictures in a way you like, I would recommend to lock the picture layer, because then you can work on the calendar itself without changing the pictures in the background. I would also take the months. We can just copy them from here and give the months a new text frame. And of course, the months should have the biggest size on each page, for example, like this. And actually you can really go fancy with this. So I have a really nice site where you can get a lot of fonts. It's called dafont.com. And here you can download a lot of free fonts that you can use for a calendar. So to give it a really nice and unique layout. If your text is difficult to read, you could also think about giving it a little border. So if we go on color, we select the text. And on here we click on add stroke. We can, for example, give it this white border here. Yeah, maybe this doesn't look so nice right now, but just play around and I see you in a second with my finished calendar. All right, now my calendar is finished and you see here the front and the back page. This picture will be wrapped around the whole book in the end when it's printed. And we can also take a look at the other pages. For example, this flower here or this one. And there are a few things that are changed. For example, I centered the table in this text box to have it centered in the right part of the picture. And also one tip I want to give you, if you right click and go on cell options, I choose the cell inset to 0, so that all the text in here can be a little bit bigger without disappearing. Okay, I think now it's a good time to export the actual pictures. To do this, we're going to go on File, Export, and in here we choose JPEG. Let's call this one exp, and we save this. And the range should be 3 to 16, because the front cover, we need to have them separate. And we activate spreads. This way, it won't export single pages. It will export the whole spread as one page. We should choose a resolution of 300 pixels per inch, and of course, a maximum quality. We can click on export. And you see here how our pictures get exported. It's also a good idea to look at them again and check if everything is okay. I think this looks okay so far. Yep, let's go back to InDesign. Now we need to take care of our cover page, this one here. And we again go on export. Let's call this one export front back. We click on save, but this time we deactivate spreads and we say the range should be the first and second page. We can click on export again. And now we see it exports some more pictures. And this one is just the back page and the front page. We have to do it this way because the website we are going to upload those things only accepts the front and the back as single pages. Alright, this is now the tricky part, the website where you upload your pictures. We start with the back and front side of our book. Just drag the pictures in here. And then it depends on the side where you are, you need to resize them and scale them in the way that they fit to your page. You can also zoom in to line them perfectly. And we can move on to the next page. We take the first month. You see now it only works for one page. To make it work for both, you can click this symbol. Your photo servers have hopefully something similar. And again, we scale the picture. We will continue this for the rest of the pages. When layouting your pictures, you should make sure that the picture itself covers also the red area of this page here, because this will also get printed and it will get cut at the red edge here. So it always gets a little bit more printed than needed. So if you cut something, that you don't end up with some white borders at some page parts. If you're happy with the calendar, also check that the months are in the right order. And you also can take a look at the preview, like this. And actually, on the front page, I'm not really sure why we have this area here. This would suggest that it gets cut in half here. So if we print this one, it might happen that it actually gets bounced on those two sides. I'm not really sure about it, but I will leave it like this and we see what happens. And now we can order our book.
Alright, and there we have our nice photo book. Even the wrapping around, you see here the front page and the back page did work pretty good. So you see the flowers wrapping around from the front to the back page. This can be a really nice personal gift with your own pictures. So I hope you give it a try and I hope also you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, see you. Bye bye.